Today we are supposed to design this particular form.
When you put words to a page, balance a budget, or share your latest idea, Office is at the center of your work. Whether you're a pro or brand new, knowing the basics helps bring your work to the next level. With the latest version of Office, Tell Me lets you ask for help in your own words. Just type what you want. You can use smart art to share your ideas visually, templates to give your documents a professional look, and charts, styles, and themes to help your pages stand out. When you're ready, you can collaborate on a document at the same time with others. Share feedback in comments and keep track of changes while you work together to turn that drab budget into a world-class report. When you're finished, store and share your files with OneDrive so you can get to them from anywhere. Explore the video courses at office.com/training and push your confidence in Office to new heights by getting back to basics.
All right, good morning. Today we are supposed to design this particular form. And this particular work has been selected carefully so that as we work on it, we'll be using the important tools in Microsoft Word that we are supposed to know how to use. And by using those tools, we will perfect our skills in Microsoft Word. And so we are using this approach of working on practical works to learn the program very well. So let me start the program and we'll begin. All right, so we'll start this work by going to blank document. You click on blank document. Now that we have a blank document, we have to plan how this work is going to be done. And so when you study this work carefully, you realize that there is a section at the top here that has a background shading. So we need to think about how we can get something like this done and have the background shading and the text appear this particular way. And what comes to mind is that a table was used over here. And so to be able to do this, we need to make use of a table. So let me open to the program and go to Insert, Table. Once I come to Insert Table, I'll be able to choose the number of rows and number of columns. In Microsoft Word, you need to select the number of rows and the number of columns. So the columns are horizontal and the rows are vertical. The columns are horizontal and the rows are vertical. Looking at this particular work, we'll need just one row with two columns. So I'll select one row and two columns like this. All right. So with something like this, I can see that we have a logo here and we have some text here that says maintenance work order form. So we'll have to put our logo in this particular table. So we'll come here and insert our logo, and over here we will input the message. So let me look for the logo to use, and I will search for it. So I have the logo right here. This logo, I can come to Microsoft Word, go to the Insert tab, and select this right here. Over here we have pictures. We click on pictures and this device. When that opens, I will search for the logo When I find it, I will click on insert. So when I click insert, the logo appears here. Now this logo looks much larger than it is in this particular project work. So what I have to do is to reduce the size. We learned before that we don't reduce image sizes from the right, because if you do that, you distort the image. We don't reduce image sizes from the left as well, because the same thing will happen. Also, we don't reduce image sizes from the bottom, because it will also distort it. And the same way, we don't reduce image sizes from the top. Anytime you are working with an image, you need to ask yourself whether the image is a complete work or it is just a shape. If it is just a shape, you can go ahead and resize the shape from the right, left, bottom, or top. But if it is a complete work, you can never use those handles to resize. And so for something like this, it looks complete. So you need to use the bottom right, the top right, top left, or the bottom left. So let me use the bottom right to resize. So you need to remember how to handle images in Microsoft Word. If the image is a complete image, you need to use the diagonal handles to resize. And you can see that when you resize, it resizes the image according to its proportion or aspect ratio. So the width and the height are all resized at the same time, and the aspect ratio of the image is maintained. The image is not squeezed like this. It is not squeezed any other way. It is just becoming smaller, and the aspect ratio remains the same. All right. When I inspect this very well, I can see that the spaces around this image is still too much. And so what I will do is that I will need to crop some of them off. Working with images, you need to learn resizing, you need to learn cropping, and you need to learn how to adjust the brightness of the image. Right now, we want to do cropping. To do cropping, you have to click, make sure you have clicked on the image. When you do that, you are going to see a new tab appear here that says picture tools. Under picture tools, we see picture formats. Under this picture format, when you move to the far right, you are going to see crop over here. When you click on crop, crop allows you to crop your image. So these handles will appear and they will help you to crop your image. So I can use this to crop the bottom parts, and cropping means you are cutting off some parts. Over here, I can crop here a little. I can crop here. I can also crop the left side. Once I do this, I will click outside and the cropping handles will disappear. Then I'll come here and check and see if it looks okay. I think the bottom and the top should be cropped a little bit more. So I'll go to picture format, crop, and I will crop the bottom a little bit and the top as well. Let me close this part too a little bit, and I think my image is now coming together. So I'll click outside and I'll check again. The only thing I see now is the size. It has to be a little smaller, so I'll reduce the size and make it much smaller. So when I check this, I think this is way smaller than what I'm seeing. So I'll undo and I'll resize again and leave it somewhere like this. Now over here, I'm going to type maintenance work order form. So I'll come here and I'll type it, maintenance work order form. All right. So once the typing is done, what I need to do is to format it for it to appear this way. So I need to do some formatting. Now, when I look at this work carefully, I realize that the space at the top here is quite small, and the space I have here is way too much, so I have to adjust the margins. When you are working with Microsoft Word, there are a number of things you will do. So even this little work I've done, you've seen that I've made use of tables, I've edited images, and now I'm coming to work on the margins. To work on the margins, I'll click outside the table first so that my margins will show clearly. When you look up here, you can see that the margin left is showing here and the margin right is also showing here, or the right margin is also showing here. I can see my margins clearly. When I come here, I can see the top margin here showing clearly, and when I go down, I'll see the bottom margin also showing clearly. Now, when I am within the table, you can see that the table also comes with a different set of margins. You can see that the middle part here has a margin handle, and this part also has one. This part also has one, because the table has two columns. That is why I'm seeing that. And again, that is why I said I'll click outside this table. Now that I'm outside, I can adjust my margins very well. If I want to adjust the top margin, this is how I'll do it. All you have to do is to come up here and adjust this margin and make it the way you want. I think this is okay for what I saw. Then when I check here again, the left margin, this is a space they have provided. The right margin, this is a space they have provided. Let's see how I can achieve that. I'll come up here and take the right margin, the left margin, and drag it till I get something like this. Okay, so something like this should work. I'll move to the far right and adjust the right margins that same way as well. Now, over here, we have what is called a ruler. You can use a ruler and the specific dimension to set your margins as well. You can set your margins by using the ruler and the dimensions on the ruler to set your margins. All right, we'll talk more about margins later. Now that I have worked on the top margin, let's see how I can make this appear. I can make mine look just like that. So what I will do is to, first of all, reduce the left column. This left column is open too much. I would have to close it up. To close it up, I'll have to hold this column bar here or border here and drag it. Now, to be able to drag, you need to make sure your pointer changes to this particular pointer. If it doesn't change to this, you cannot move it. So because I have it, I can hold and drag it. So now I have something like this, and let me zoom out and see. Okay, I can see that the right border here is also creating too much space here. So I can come up here and close this up to get to the same place the right margin got to. So I think it is beginning to look similar. The next thing I will do is to work on this particular font, the maintenance work order form. I'll work on its font. So to do that, I will come here and study how this looks, and I will apply similar effects. So I'll highlight everything here and change the style to heading 1. Over here we have the styles group. You can choose several styles. We have the title styles, we have heading 1. I want to use the heading 1 style. I'll click on the heading 1 and it will appear this way. Now that it appears this way, I will come up here and select the layout. This particular layout, when you click on this layout, you will see the alignment appear in 9 boxes like this. So you can see that one of them is selected, which is the top left one. And because the top left is selected, that is why my text is also appearing at the top left. I want my text to appear in the middle and still align to the left. So I'll choose this particular one here, and I'll see that the alignment is the same. Also, I can see that there's a space on top of the text, and this particular space, I don't need it. I need to clear it off, because when you look at the text very well, you can see that it is not perfectly in the middle. It's like there's more space at the top and less space at the bottom. It is because of the space we are seeing here. This particular space is called paragraph spacing. To be able to use Microsoft Word effectively, you need to understand paragraph spacing. Paragraph spacing is on the Home tab, and it can be found in the Paragraphs group. Under the Paragraphs group, you can see this command here that says line and paragraph spacing. When you select the arrow, you will see line spacing options here. There are several line spacing options here. We are not interested in the line spacing, but the bottom two, the last two here, talks about paragraphs. The last two here are about paragraphs. And the first one, what it says is that remove space before paragraph. It is telling us to remove space before paragraph because there is space here before this text. So this is a feature that Microsoft Word has set in that will automatically create some spaces either before or after paragraph. Over here, you can see that it is saying add space after paragraph. Sometimes Microsoft Word will add space after paragraph, and if you don't need it, you need to come here and remove it. Sometimes they will add space before paragraph. If you don't need it, you need to remove it. This time they have added space before this text and we don't need it. So we will come here and click on it, and that space will be gone. Now you can see that the text is well positioned in the middle. When you go back to the paragraph spacing, you will see that this time it is saying add space before paragraph. So anytime you come here, it is either add or remove. When you see add, it means there is no paragraph space. If you see remove, it means there is a paragraph space that you need to remove. To be able to format your Microsoft Word documents the way you want, you have to pay close attention to this paragraph spacing, because sometimes they will appear where you don't need them and you'll have to remove them. Sometimes they will not appear where they are supposed to appear and you'll have to add them. So this paragraph spacing, they affect our works a lot, and so we need to pay attention to them. All right, now that I can see this, I want to continue with my formatting. I'll highlight again, and I think the font that was used here is called Calibri Light, and I don't want the light because it is making it too light. So I'll change it to the normal Calibri for Calibri body. Once I choose normal Calibri, I can see that it's a little bit thicker. Then I'll go ahead and select B for bold, and it will appear in bold. I think the font size also needs to increase. I will increase the font size to 20. Let me check again, and I think I have to increase the font size to 24. So I have, and I think this what will be fine. Now I can see that the background of these two columns needs to be dark green. So I'll highlight the entire columns, and I'll move to where we set fill colors. So this is fill color or shading, and that means a background color. And I'll come here and choose. I think this is the one I'm supposed to use. Once I select this, I can see that the background is shaded, and I think I have the same color. What I need to do to this text is to change the text color to white. Remember, I came here for the fill color or the shading color, and that uses a bucket. If you want to color text, you need to come to the font color where you see A. So I'll click here and select the color I want. Now my color is white and my work is coming together. Right now, I think I can see some black borders around this table, and I cannot see those black borders here. So I want to clear them. I'll highlight the two columns again, or I can come up here and click on this particular handle once. Once I select it, it will highlight everything, and I can now apply my effect. On the Home tab, I will come to where we set borders. This is where we set borders. And what I can do is to click on the arrow and select this option that says no border. Once I select this option that says no border, I think the borders are gone. Now let me check my work again. The only thing I see is that I can see the green running or wrapping around this logo, but mine is not like that. To do that, I will increase the height of my table a little bit, just a little bit, and the logo. I'll click on the logo and check its layout. Once I check the layout of the logo, I can see that it is at the top left, and that is why it is not fitting in the middle. So I'll come here and choose this particular layout and see if it will work. After choosing that, I think I have the top well formatted. When I compare this to that, I think I have the same thing, or I'm very, very close. This time I want you to try this and get this done. Then we will continue from here. All right, so let's continue. So when you look at the original work, you can see that we have dates over here, and the date is aligned to the right. So we need to have the date in hours. To do that, we will go ahead and just type date, colon, with space, and then dot, 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 something like this. Then you press enter, and before we align it to the right, let's input the next text here. I can see client information. So you just come here and type client information. After typing this client information, we will now align the date to the right. So we will come here and click to highlight the date. Then we move it to the right. So now the date is aligned to the right. Let me check the number of dots and see if mine are more or less. When I look at the original, I think I have more dots than the original work. So I'll come here and clear some of my dots. Let's see. Let me just add a few more, and I think I'm okay. So now let's go ahead with the client information. So now that I have client information, I would have to check here and see the formatting. Usually in Microsoft Word, before formatting is done, you need to move the cursor to the bottom before you apply your formatting. So after typing client information, I'll not just start formatting this client information. I'll leave it like that, come here and hit enter first. Because if I don't break the line and I start formatting, the formatting I will do here will affect the remaining lines. So if I move down, they are all going to have the same formatting. But the formatting, I only want it to apply to the text here. That is why I broke the line. So now I'll highlight this text and format it to look like this. Now, when I study this, I think first of all, the font size is bigger than mine. So I will try and get the font size to be equal. So Let's see 18 and make it bold. Let's check and see. I think I have it now. Then the next thing to do is the color. Let me come to the text color or font color and try and choose this green color. This green color. Once I choose green from the standard colors, green, I think I have green. The last thing to do is the bottom line here. To get this, I need to use what is called the bottom border. So I'll leave it highlighted, come to where we set our borders, and I will select bottom border. Now, when I select bottom border, I think my border will not look like the original. I can see that this border is thicker than mine. So what do I do? To do that, I need to change the border settings. So I'll highlight it again, go back to where I set the borders, and this time I will click on it and move down to what is called borders and shading. Once I click on borders and shading, I'll have the option to adjust the borders. I'll not touch the styles, I'll not touch the color, I'll only work on the width. So I'll come here and I'll choose a width like 1.5 point. When I choose this, I'll click OK and check if it has applied. I think it has not applied, so I'll come back here to where we set our borders and I'll select border bottom again. Once I select it again, this time it's going to be thick. So now I'll compare it with this and see which one is thicker. I think the original is a little bit thicker than mine. Let me highlight it and check it again. I'll go back to borders and shading and check the points. I think I will try the next one, 2.25 points, and click OK. Select this and click bottom border again. And now I'll compare. I think mine is thicker this time, so what I did before was right. I'll just go back, or I'll just undo. Let me just undo, and it's fine. All right, so it looks okay now. Now, I want you to enter your date and this client information like this, and let's see if you can format yours that way. All right, so now we'll continue. When you look at the original, we have another table here, and I can see 1, 2, 3 columns and 1, 2, 2 rows. So I'll create a table, and to create a table, I'll go to insert and I'll click on table. Then I have 3 columns, so I'll select 1, 2, 3 and 2 rows, 1, 2, so 3 by 2. When I click on it, I'll have a 3 by 2 table. Also, if you want to insert table, make sure your cursor, you have more space at the bottom. If not, after inserting the table, it will be difficult for you to continue working. So I have the space, I don't have a problem. But before, let me undo and show you. Before you insert the table, press enter about twice. Then you come and click up here again before you insert your table. And after inserting the table, you have some space down to continue working. If not, when you just insert the table, you will not have space to input any text after the table. All right, so now I'll be here. Then I'll go to insert table, 3 columns, 2 rows. Then okay. Once I do that, I have my table. Let me compare this table to the original work and see what problem I'm having. First of all, when I check the original work, I can see that there is space here before the name of clients. Let me zoom in a little. Before this name of client, there's space here, so I need to make sure I also have that space. So when I check mine, I don't have that space over there. So I think I will undo my table and come here and hit enter first. I'll hit enter before inserting my table. So I'll go to insert table 3 by 2. Now I have space there. The space later, I will adjust the space to look the same like the original. Now let me check the table itself and see if the table itself is okay. When I check the table, When I check the original table, I can see that the table borders here are a little bit thinner than what I'm seeing here. My table borders look a little bit thicker, just a little bit. So what I will do is that I will click on this handle to highlight the table, go to the Home tab, select the borders drop down, and come down to borders and shading. When I get to borders and shading, I'll select the width and change the width to 1/4 or 1/4, 1/4 points. Once I choose this and I click OK, I can see that immediately my table width, the thickness of my table borders have reduced. So the thickness of my table borders have reduced, and now my table looks like the original. Let me go ahead and input the text. Over here we have name of client, phone numbers, email address. So I'll come here and enter name of client, here phone numbers or phone number into bracket S, then we'll have email address. All right, again I'll check the original, and when I do, I can see that the original is bold, and let me make mine bold. I can highlight all of them here and select bold and see if they are the same. I think I'll leave it that way. Now let me work on the space at the top here. I think my space looks way too much. What is creating this big space over here? I just need a small space. When you check the original work, you can see that the space here is something like this. But when you check my work, you can see that my space is way too tall. So I'll have to clear or reduce the space over there. To do that, I will move backwards and click. When I click like this, I'll get a highlighting done over here. The highlighting over here, I can see that it looks too long, and that tells me there's a paragraph spacing in it. So I'll go to the Home tab, go to where the paragraph spacing are, then I will check. I can see that indeed there's one of them. So I need to click on this to remove space after paragraph. I'll click on this to remove space after paragraph, and let me check again. My space has reduced. Even though it has reduced, it is still not like the original. I can still see some gap here, and this gap, I don't understand why it is there. I want to clear it. And I can see again that the gap is not part of my highlighting. So I'll highlight this line and see. When I highlight this line, I can see that there is the gap is in that selection. So this gap here, I need to clear it. From my experience, you know that this is also paragraph spacing. So to remove it, I'll go to the Home tab under the paragraphs group. I'll click on line and paragraph spacing, and I'll check down here, and indeed I can see that there is spacing there. I'll select remove space after paragraph. This time when I check again, my spacing is okay for me, and it looks exactly like the original one. So now I have fixed this. Let me check the original again. I can see another table that says address. So what I will do is to insert that table. So I'll come here, make sure I have space here because I can see some space in between the two tables. So over here, I'll make sure I have one space here, and I'll move to the next line. Then I will click on insert table. Now when you check here, the table is just one column with two rows. Okay, so I'll insert a new table. I'll go to insert one column, two rows. So I have a new table there with one column, two row. I'll check what is in. It says address. I'll type address. Now the address needs to be formatted just like what I have here. And I'll use this opportunity to introduce you to what is called the Format Painter. The Format Painter is an interesting tool in Microsoft Word. what happens is that you can use a format painter to copy any formatting and apply it anywhere. For example, the formatting here, if I want to apply this same formatting to this text, I will highlight this and I'll come up here on the home tab in the clipboard group. You'll see something here known as format painter. When I click on the format painter, I can come here and apply the format painter to any text. I can click in the middle of the text or I can highlight. Immediately you click or highlight, it will apply the formatting you copied into it. Again, this does not change the text. It is not like copy and paste. It is copy and paste, but it is only copying the styling or the formatting and pasting it. All right, this is not the formatting I want. I want this formatting. So I'll highlight this, any of them. I can even click in the middle and go to the format painter, pick it. Once I pick the format painter, I will come and highlight this text from here to here, and it will apply that formatting. This is an intelligent way of formatting your work. I can see here that this particular table looks thicker than the first one. So I will click on this to highlight the table. Just like we did before, we'll go to where we have our borders, go down to borders and shading. Then I will check the table width. I can see that it is 1/2. That is why it looks thicker. So I'll choose a 1/4 and click OK. Once I do that, the table will look thin and clean and nice. Also, I can see that there is space here, and the spacing here is too much. It's not like the original. So what I will do is to come here, click on this to highlight, and I can see that this looks so long. From experience, you will know that paragraph spacing is applied there, so you have to clear the paragraph spacing. I'll go to the home tab, I'll move to the line and paragraph spacing, and I'll select remove space after paragraph. Once I do that, the spacing is now perfectly okay, and my work looks very neat. Now, if this video is moving too fast, you can pause it and do what I've done before you continue. All right, so let's continue with our work. When I check the original again, I can see that we have work description. This work description, I can either type it or just copy what I have here, copy, come down here and paste. Once I paste this, I can see that it is very similar to what I want to achieve. So instead of typing it myself, I will just highlight the text here. And what I will do, I will type work description. And this has saved me a lot of time, because if I had typed it raw, I would have to start the formatting and the styling all over. So what I did was to come here, click here and copy the styling we did here. I pasted it here. I duplicated it. Then I highlighted the text and I edited the text, and now it looks just like what we need. Over here, we can see another table that has 1, 2, 3, 4 columns and 2 rows. So I'll come here, click here, hit enter for some space. Then I'll go to insert table. Columns are 4. So I'll select 1, 2, 3, 4, and rows are 2, 4 by 2. Click OK, and I have a new table. In this new table, I'm supposed to enter maintenance ID, priority of work, estimated start date, estimated end date. So I'll come here and I'll do that typing here. We have maintenance ID, we have priority of work, we have estimated start date, and we have estimated end date. All right, now I want to apply the formatting we've been using to all of these. What will I do? I'll just come to any of them, click in the middle or highlight, and go to the format painter on the home tab and click on it. Once I click on it, I will come here and highlight from here down to here, and when I release, the formatting will be applied to it. Isn't this amazing? So this is the format painter, and it helps you to work really fast. Now I can see that I have some spacing in between the work description and the table here, and the spacing is too much. When I highlight the space, I can see that it looks too long, and from experience you will know that it has paragraph spacing. So I need to clear the paragraph spacing. Remember how to clear the paragraph spacing? Just go to the home tab, move to the paragraph group, click on the line and paragraph spacing, move down and check. If you see remove space after paragraph or before paragraph, then it means there is really spacing. So I'll click on this remove, and the spacing will remove, and my work looks very neat now. Let's check here, and now the rest are not that difficult. So I have detailed description of work required. So I'll come here, hit enter, detailed description of work required. Then I would have to enter 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines. These 5 lines, I'm not going to use the border lines or bottom border like we did before. I'm going to use what is called underscore. So this underscore is a key on your keyboard. It's a key for hyphen or dash. That same key, when you hold shift before pressing it, it will create the underscore. So I'll enter underscore several of them till I get to the end. If it breaks to a new line, what I will do is to clear what is showing on the new line, and I'll leave this like that. Now, when I compare my underscore to this work, I can see that this one looks thinner than mine here. So I'll highlight and check something. Let me check the font that was used. It is Calibri Bold. I'll change this Calibri Bold to Calibri Light. The font size, I'll change this to 8 and check. Now I think it looks perfect. Let me move to the right and see, it has reduced in size. So let me just add more. Shift, then underscore, underscore, till I have just enough for this work. I think it looks great. So now that I have this, I will come here and click to highlight. I'll press Ctrl C on my keyboard to copy. Then Ctrl V, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, to paste it 5 times. So now that I've pasted it 5 times, it looks great. This is exactly what I'm supposed to create, and I have. Let me check here and see what I have not done. I think the spacing between the table and the detailed description is too long. Let me come here, highlight that space. When you check, you see that the space here is too long. So from experience, you will know that there's a paragraph spacing. I'll go to the home tab, move to the paragraphs group, and I will check. Of course, I can see remove. So when I click on remove, it will remove the paragraph spacing. So this has also been done for me, and I think my work is now very easy to complete. Let me check the original again, and we have another set that says additional comments. So to type the additional comments, let me come here and select this. Let me apply the formatting here. Format painter, apply formatting to this. This has moved up too much. Let me hit enter to bring it down, and let me check if it's okay. Let me remove the paragraph spacing here and see what will happen. Okay, so I think it looks okay now. All right, so I'll come here and highlight everything here, and I think I'll just pick 3 of the lines because I don't need all 5. I'll come here, press enter and paste, and I'll check this. I think I have what I need. So I'll just edit this text and type additional comments. Now when you do this, it saves you time because I'm done. If I had done everything from scratch, I would have had to create all these lines again. Now the spacing here is too long. Let me reduce it. From experience, I know that there is definitely line spacing, so I'll just highlight it go to the Home tab, paragraph and line spacing, remove space after paragraph, and I think it looks great. I think the last thing to add will be work authorization. The work authorization title looks like this. I'll click here and copy Ctrl C. Come here, click where I want it to appear and press Ctrl V. It looks great. I'll highlight this text and I will edit it. So I'll type work authorization. Let me check if that's what I'm supposed to type. Yes, and it looks okay. Let me check the spacing here. I think it is too long. Let me check. There is remove space after paragraph. I'll remove it and I think it looks great. Now I need to input some small information down there and my work will be done. So what I will do here is to enter some underscores and type the following: work authorized by, position authorized signature. Let me highlight some of the underscores from here just to save me time. Ctrl C to copy, paste here, press tab, let me check, tab again and paste, enter. I'll type work authorized by, tab, and I'll type position, enter, paste the underscore I copied, enter, and it's created a line automatically, so I just press undo and the line is gone. So I need to type authorized signature. Now if you look at my work, the problem I'm having now is that my work has moved to a new line. When they give you any assignment and it's on one page, you have to let yours be on the same page or also fit in one page. My work has moved to a new page, so I need to solve that. I'll click inside the old page and I realize that I didn't adjust my bottom margins. So I come here and I adjust the bottom margins like this, and I think authorized signature will show on this page. Still, I can see a second page there. The second page, I'll click a little bit down into it and press backspace 1, 2 till it disappears. Now the second page is gone, completely gone. What I want to do now is to apply the formatting to this text here. So I'll highlight any of these, pick the format painter, copy, paste the formatting here, pick the format painter here, paste it here, and now I'm almost there. Backspace. So let me check the original again. I think the spacing between this line and the work authorized by, they are too much. To do that, I'll highlight this here and I can see that there's paragraph spacing here. This paragraph spacing, you can see how many times I have used it. In Microsoft Word, you have to understand paragraph spacing because it will immensely affect your work. If you don't know how to deal with it, your work will never look the way it's supposed to. So here I can see this error here. I'll go to the paragraph spacing and remove it. And I think next time the program should be more intelligent in applying the paragraph spacing, because sometimes where they apply it, you don't need it and you have to go and remove it. But they are assuming it's a paragraph, so you should have it. So I think if the program is more intelligent, it should know when we need paragraph spacing and when we don't. When we need it, we can apply it ourselves. And when you don't, it shouldn't appear at all. All right, so authorized signature, I can see the same error here. I need to clear that spacing. So I'll go to the paragraph spacing and I'll come here, remove spacing after paragraph, and voila, this is done. So when I check my work now, let me see, compare it with the original. I think my work looks very similar to the original work. It looks very similar. Let me check what I have not done. I think at the top here, the spacing here are too much. I can see some paragraph spacing. Let me clear the paragraph spacing and the top is looking fine now. Okay, so over here I made a mistake. Let me undo Over here, we need some spacing here to be able to write the date well. But what I need to clear is the spacing under the date. So I'll highlight the date, go to paragraph spacing and remove, and it will look fine. So this is exactly what I need. I'll highlight these two again, and this time I'm not changing paragraph spacing, I'm changing line spacing. So I'll change the line spacing to 1.0, and this part will look okay because I want them to appear close to each other. Because there's white space here, if I let it go down too much, it will not look professional. So now I think my work is beautifully done and I'm done working. What I need to do now is to save my work and get it ready for printing. So I'll go to File, click on Save, choose my save location. All right, so I'll choose Browse and I'll look for my save location. I'll just look for it wherever I want to save it. I think this way I want to save it, and it's called maintenance work order. I already have a copy done, so I'll just come here and say class work dash maintenance work order, save. Now my work is saved. If I want to make it PDF, I can just make it PDF. If I want to print, I can go ahead and print. So this work is done. I think I want to save it as PDF. Watch how PDF is saved. To save a document as PDF, click on File, and instead of save, click on Save As. Instead of save, click on Save As. When you click on Save As, what will happen is that it will behave as if you've not even saved it and you are now about to save it. So I click on Browse now and look for the location. I think I'm okay with this destination, but what will make it the PDF is this, the Save As type. Instead of Microsoft Word document, click here and change it to PDF. Once you see PDF here, it means your work will be saved as PDF, not as Microsoft Word. So I'll select the PDF and save, and I'll see that my work will save as PDF. Let me go and look for it, and immediately I can see it right here as a PDF. Let me double click on it and I have it in PDF. This is so nice. It looks great. One page, it looks great. Let me compare it with the original, and I'm finding it difficult to tell the difference. This is very beautiful. So I want to thank you for taking time to join us in this class. Thank you for going through this project work with us. If anything was too fast, I want you to pause the video and go back and check and fix whatever you are finding difficulty with. So take your time and get this work done. I'm going to attach my work files in the description below. If you have any question, put it in the comment box and I'll answer you. And I want you to like this video and share it with your friends. Subscribe to this channel and be part of us. Thank you once again, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.